Yeah, good morning, children. You might have got the news that next week, that is on 12th, 13th, 14th, you will be having your first round test. Great. Then, in that week till the Monday class, in that week till the Monday class, or you might also get the video till Wednesday. Wednesday, you keep it in your mind that till Wednesday, whatever the video or whatever the notes regarding the maths topic you get, it will be there for your examination, that is for your test, that is the first round test. You will be having arithmetic progression. I have decided to give you two exercises. Some of the first 10 terms of an arithmetic progression. If the video has been started on the Monday class, it will be there for your exam, the test. If it is not there on the Monday class, so you won't have the some of the nth term of an arithmetic progression for your first round test. Okay, the first exercise and the second exercise regarding your AN. Regarding your AN, you will be having. So please do learn it carefully since you get the question paper in your home itself. And to please not copy it, children. Whatever you know, whatever you have understood when you see the video and whatever the notes you have written, whatever you understand, please do copy it. Please do write your test by your own. Do not copy, okay? Because you are going to write the examination, right? You are not 9th standard or 8th standard children. Well, since you have one more year for your 10th. No, you are the 10th standard children. You will be writing your examination. Great. For that, you just practice from now onwards itself, so it will be very easy for your exam. Clear? Then, regarding the test, it is over. Then, I have come that you are very clear with the videos, what I have written, the things on the board. You will copy it down. Yeah, sure, you can copy it down in your classwork. If the video is not clear, if you get a blurness in the video, then you can copy it as the PDF comes. You can copy it down, but make sure how much of a video has completed, how much of our notes have completed in the video. Please do understand the things. If you have any doubts, you can come and ask when your classwork and the homework is being corrected. And maintain your classwork and homework. I want all your classworks and homeworks to be submitted on time before the test. Okay, test portion should be complete, should be corrected before the test itself. It cannot be corrected after the test. I want everybody's classwork in the next week, that is on Monday. Understood? Yeah. Then coming to the topic, that is the arithmetic progression, we'll continue with that. How are you going to write the general that is general form? General form. How are you going to write the general form? I'm not able to hear. Please tell the general form. How are you going to write the general form? That is A plus B, A plus 2D, and it goes on up to AN. That is A plus N minus 1 into D. Please do remember, children, you will always be solving the problem based on this itself. Okay? This formula itself. That is the general form. Then, general equation. What is the formula for the general equation? An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Correct. A plus N minus 1 into D. What is An? An is the nth term. An is always the nth term. Do not use the margin for your working. Please do draw a working column as I have divided the board as the repeated class and the things what I wanted to do it on the board. So like this itself, you are also going to divide your classwork, that is the working column and the main column. You do whatever the working you want to do it in the working column. Okay. A is the nth term, or you can tell it as a last term. A is always the first term. N is the number of terms. You cannot say it as nth term, it is number of terms. Then D is the common difference. How are you going to find the common difference? D is equal to A2 minus A1. If not, then A3 minus A2. If not, A4 minus A3. What will be the common difference for the last one? It is A is equal to AN minus 1 is the common difference for the last term of the given arithmetic sequence. Clear? These were the things what you learned, and then in the yesterday, that is the previous class, you had learned about when they give you in the word, and the wordings form question has been converted into the numerical form, and then you have solved it. Great. Then in today's class, we are going to continue with the exercise 2.1.2 itself. 1.2 itself, we are going to continue with the same. Okay, then it is the question number 8. We need to solve question number 8, correct? Yeah. Since these problems are of only one type, please do it in your classwork as well as in the homework to make you familiar with the questions. What type of questions you might get. An arithmetic progression consists of 50 terms, of which third term is 12 and the last term is 106. Find the 29th term. What they have told an AP consists of what they have told. An AP which is consisting of, this is a question, an AP which is consisting of 50 terms. 50th term, if they had stressed you for 50th term, then you would have taken it as A50. But here it is 50 terms. So what is n value? What is n value? 50. Yes. Then, so how many numbers do you have in the sequence? You have 50 numbers in the sequence. The last will be the 50th one. Okay. Then, of which third term is 12? So what they have told? Third. Three terms. No, it is third term. So it is A3. If it was three terms, then you would have taken n is equal to 3. But here it is third term. Please do understand, fourth standard. In fourth standard, you have 50 members. Correct. So AN is not 50. N is 50 in third standard. So like that. Third term is 12. Then what? And the last term is 106. What is the last term? What is the last term you have? That is 50th term. That is AN is equal to 50 is the last term. The sequence has 50 terms in the sequence. Okay, what is the last term? The last term is 50. So, what they have given? A50 is how much children? So, it is 106. Then, what are you going to find? A29th term. Yeah, you should find A29th term. Correct? See, look at the question carefully. 50 terms ko 50th term ko vyathyasa ide. See, they have given the n value first and they have told the last number is that. So, if you have a sequence of 150 numbers will be there in the sequence and they will tell you the last number is 106. So, what is the last number you have? 150 is the last number. So, n, that is A150 is equal to 106. Like that. Understood? So, now, the things are clear. That is n value you know, A3 value you know, A50 value you know, and A29 value you know. Now, how are you going to solve this? You are going to solve this as you have solved the missing numbers, missing sequences in the box. Box sums was there, no? Like that only you are going to solve this. Okay. Now, let me take A3 is equal to 12. How are you going to write it in the general form? A3, if you do not know to write it in the general form, if you are not able to write it in the general form, it is confusing. Write it in the side. An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So, what is that A3? A3 is equal to A, I do not know. N, I know. What is the N value? 3 minus 1. D, I do not know. So, it is A plus 2D. What is A3? How are you going to write A3? A plus 2D is equal to 12. Then, A50 is how much? 106. How are you going to write A50? N minus 1. 50 minus 1 is 49. So, A plus 49D is equal to 106. It's equation number 1, equation number 2. Now, you are going to subtract both the equations. What you get? A plus 49D is equal to 106. A plus 2D is equal to 12. Correct? Since I do not have... Now, what are you going to do? You are going to do it in the elimination method. Correct? Now, I am not having same sign. What I am going to do? You are going to change the sign. Eliminate matter. One term, I will eliminate. So, A value, I have constant. So, it gets cancelled. In 49, if 2 goes, how much? 47D is equal to... So, in 6, 2 goes, it is 4... In 10, 1 goes, it is 9. So, you get 94. If the subtraction or some addition, the cancellation, if it is wrong, I'm very sorry for that. While doing the sum, it happens with it. Please do adjust with it. I'm really sorry. I won't do it purposely, but it happens. Then it is 49 minus 2 is 47 itself, and 106 minus 12 it is 94. Yeah. So now what I'm going to do, 94 divided by 47. 94 divided by 47, 94 and 7. 7, you can do it with 3 ones. 3 ones can you do? Because the last term is 7. You get 3 9s as 27. No, I cannot. 3 ones are 3, 17 won't go. 94. No. Let me keep it as it is. Okay. Let me keep the D value as it is. Let me substitute in equation number 1. What happens? Let's see. If I substitute in equation number 1, A plus 2 into 94 divided by 47. Which is equal to, what is the value you have? 12. What is the value you have? You have it as 12. But 7, 2 is 14, right? It goes. 41, 47 ones are, 47 twos are. It goes in 47 table itself. So D value you get it as 2. 7 twos are 14. So 4 is there. No, for that I made it. I checked it whether it goes or not. So you get D value as 2. So in equation number 1, you are going to substitute D value. Okay. Now what happens? A plus 2 twos are 4 is equal to 12. If 4 goes outside, what happens? 12 minus 4, which is equal to, how much children? 12 minus 4, it is 8. So what is the value of A? Value of A is 8. Value of D is 2. Now you came to know value of D and value of A. Now let us substitute. Let us substitute that we need to find A 29. Correct. How are you going to write A 29 in the general form? It is A plus N minus 1. 29 minus 1 is 28D. Correct? 29 minus 1 is what? 29, 28D. So what is the A value? You got A value as 2 plus 28 into, what is D value? 2 itself. 28 plus 2 8s are 16, 1 carry, 2 2s are 4 plus 1 is 5. So it is 56, correct? Then 56 plus 4 is 60. 60 plus 4 is 64. So A 29 you get it as 64. Did you understand, children? Here we have wrote it in the general form. If you are not able to write it in the general form, do not worry. Write the general formula, that is A plus N minus 1 into D. Substitute the N value what you have. You get the general form. Please do substitute it there. It is equal to 12. And similarly, 50 minus 1 is 49D. And similarly, 29 minus 1 is 28D. Okay, now everything is in general form. Now what I'm going to do, I need to find 29th term, so let me keep it aside. Now I've got two equations. Due to the elimination method, I'm going to cancel it. I'm going to find D value, which is equal to 2. Then I'm going to substitute the D value in equation number 1. Why I have chosen 1? Because it is easier. 12 is there. So it is easier. Here 106 and 49. It is very difficult. So I'll choose the easier one. I get the answer as 8. And I'm going to substitute in 29. That is A 29, which I've got. A 29 is equal to 64. Clear? This, I think this question is understood for you. Let me go to the ninth one. You've got textbook, children? If not, write the left two lines gap. And understand the topic and write. When I give you the notes, write. At that time, I'll write the question and I'll be giving it to you. When it is written, then copy the question from the notes. Okay, but do not wait until the notes is being given in the PDF form. See, there's so much of delay it has been happening. So, please do understand the topics and write. Okay, when the notes has been uploaded, then you check anything if it is wrong, if you have missed any step, check. do again, if you do at that time also, it would be a very good practice for you. What better work you have at home now? Then coming to the ninth question, if the third term and the ninth term of an arithmetic progression, that is AP, are 4 and 8, minus 8 respectively, which term of an AP is 0? So now half, we have done it in the previous class, that is the seventh question. Half we are doing now, this is a new one. So let us see both the things. What they have told, if the third term, so A3, third RD, then A3. A3 is equal to how much? 4. Then ninth TH there. So it is A9, which is equal to how much, children? Minus 8. Okay, respectively. Okay. Which term they have asked? So which term and the bantone? Nth term and the bantone. That's the N and the bantone. Which term and the bantone? N. They are talking about N. You need to find N for what? Of an AP is 0. Yeah, N term is 0 after they. They are asking you that which nth term, that is AN value they have given, which is equal to 0. Correct? Correct? They have asked which nth term is 0. So in your class, you will be having 50 students. In that, how many of them have failed? Correct. 50 then the kudai to. Ali eshna fail agidare. So you tell, ma'am, the class what I take, I have 3 members failed, right? I do not know what is the strength of the class. Correct. Now in the online class, now only you see online class, we ask which section are you? Which section are you? Because we do not know what is the strength of that section or which section you belong to. So we ask you people itself. Correct. So that only I am telling you. We do not know the strength, but we know you are belonging to this particular class. Here also, we do not know the strength, but they are saying you will be having an AP where you have nth term as 0, but we do not know which term is it. Okay, so this is the question what it has been given. Now, similarly, what we have done here, like that only we are going to do here. Okay, how are you going to write? A3 is equal to 4. How are you going to write A3? A3, you are going to write it in the general form as A plus 2D. Correct? Then A9, how are you going to write? A9 is equal to minus 8. How are you going to write? 9 minus 1 is 8. So A plus 8D, which is equal to minus 8. So this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. Now you are going to do elimination method for both the equation. If you know what happens, A plus 2D is equal to 4. A plus 8D is equal to minus 8. Now we are going to change the sign. Why? Because 8 term we have similar sign. So plus becomes minus. Plus becomes minus. Minus becomes minus itself. No, it becomes plus. Very good. Now plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled. Then which is the greater number sign? 8 is the greater number. So minus sign. In 8, if 2 goes, it is 6D. Okay, which is the greater number? 8 is the greater number. You have plus. 8 plus 4 is 12. So D is equal to, if this comes this side, it becomes 12 divided by minus 6. Or you can write it as D is equal to minus 12 divided by 6 also, children. Okay, both are in same house only. You can give you can give it to your brother first and then you can have, or you can have and then you give it to your brother, like that. Okay, so 6 1 6, 2 12. So D is equal to how much? Minus 2. D value is how much, children? You get D value as minus 2. Now you got D value. Now what do you want? I do not know A value also. I'll substitute in the first equation or the second equation to get the D value. So substituting in the first equation, what is the first equation? A plus 2D is equal to 4. Let me substitute D value here. A plus 2 into minus 2 is equal to 4. So A minus into plus is minus. 2 into 2 is 4 is equal to 4. A is equal to 4 plus 4. A is equal to 4 plus 4 is 16. 8. So 4 into 4 is 16, but 4 plus 4 is 8. Now you got to know the a value and d value. Can you substitute in an? Yes. What is the an formula? An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. I do not know n value. I need to find n value, but I know the value of an. What is the value of an? 0. And what is the value of a? 8 plus n minus 1 as it is. What is the value of d? Minus 2. So 0 is equal to a plus minus 2. Minus into minus becomes plus. Let me remove the bracket itself initially. So it is minus 2 minus minus is plus 2. So 0 is equal to. So what is there? 2 into n children. I forgot to write. Sorry. 8 plus 2 is 10 minus 2n. So if this 10 goes that side, of this 2n goes that side, anyhow you get 2n is equal to 10. So n value is equal to 10 divided by 2. So 2 ones are 2, 5s are. So what is the n value? N value is 5. Correct? What is the n value? N value is 5. Let me check. I need to check whether it is correct or not. So an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. A 5 is equal to 8 plus 4 into 2. That is A5. A5 children, A5 is equal to 8. Minus into pluses minus. 4 2s are 8. Plus 8 minus 8 is 0. Correct. My answer is correct. That is n value is 5. So when n is 5, the nth term, that is an, will be equal to 0. Therefore, what are you going to do? What are you going to conclude? A5 will be equal to 0, or you can say the fifth term of an arithmetic progression is equal to 0. Okay, basically write it in words, write it in a numerical form itself, which is in mathematics is completely based on numerical. You are not going to write it in words, therefore you are going to write A5 is equal to 0. Clear? Is it clear, children? Let us go to the next problem. That is the 10th problem. That is the 10th problem. What is the 10th problem? The 17th term of an arithmetic progression exceeds its 10th term by 7. Find the common difference. Now what they have told? A 17th, and they have told A 10th. Okay, so it is A 17 and A 10. The sum is between these two. Okay, fine. Then what they have told? Exceeds its 10th term by 7. Now you would have a doubt, ma'am, where to put this exceed and 7. Okay, I'll give you an hint. You have, what is the number you have? 17. What is your number you have? 10. For 10, how much you should put to become 7? 17. So you are going to put 7. For 10, if you put 7, you are going to get 17, which is equal to 17. Correct? Exceed and the bantu on the, you are going to take it as plus. Okay? Precede. If it is telling precede, then you are going to take minus sign. Then you are going to take minus sign. How will this question be, ma'am, for preceding? That is what? The 10th term of an arithmetic progression is preceding x 17th term by 7. So first thing what they have told? 10th term. So here you are going to write 10, which is equal to precede, and what is the next thing? 17th term. So to make this 10, okay, how did you get this 10? When you subtract 7 in 17, you get 10. Precede, subtraction. Exceed, addition. Now where will you put this 10? You are going to put, sorry, where will you put the 7? You are going to put the 7 beside the 10th term. So how is the equation? A17 is equal to A10 plus 7. Correct? 17th term is exceeding 7 times the 10th term. Arthaita, then the other way. 10th term is preceding 7 times the 17th term. How will be the equation? A10 will be equal to, let me see how you are going to tell. You write it in this form, it will be very easy to write. So it is A17 minus 7. That is preceding it, is exceeding it. Okay? They twist, children. If they won't twist, I'll twist. I'll twist the question. So make sure you understand when to put plus, when to put minus. Okay? Now proceed and then plus. What makes 17? 10 plus 7 makes 17. What makes 10? 17 minus 7 makes 10. Like that. Okay? So, I hope this equation is understood for you. Then what they have told? Continuation, find the common difference. They have asked only D. They have asked you the D value. D is equal to question mark. They have asked you the D value. Okay? Now, how are you going to write it in general form? A plus 17 minus 1 is 16D is equal to, how are you going to write this? A plus 10 minus 1 is 9D plus 7. Correct? Now, put D values on one side, put A values on another side. So, let me take, since 16 is greater, let me take all the D values to the right hand side and let me put all the A values to the left hand side. So, what happens? 16D minus 9D is equal to A minus A plus 7. Okay? So, 16 minus 9. After 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. You have 7. Correct? 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 16. Yeah, 7 is good. 7D is equal to plus A minus A gets cancelled, which is equal to 7. So, what is the D value? 7 divided by 7. 7 ones are 7 ones are. So, D value is equal to 1. Ishtekeda, they have given the question. They have asked you to find D. So, this is for 2 marks. So, this question will be for 2 marks. This is the 10th question. I hope so. Yes. Did you understand? Only this much. What do you need to remember here? Preceding, exceeding. Ashtin nenpit kombe kashte. Perena illa. Okay, if you get precede, plus. Precede, minus. Exceed, plus. Okay? So, this is the thing what you require to understand in this sum. Then, let me come to the 11th question. What is the 11th question all about? Which term of an arithmetic progression will be 132 more than its 54th term? Okay, fine. They have, let me take the sequence what they have given. So, this is the 11th term. Sorry, 11th sum. AP is 3, 15, 27, 29 and it goes on. Okay, will be 132 more than its 54th term. So, what they are given? A54. Correct? A54. They have given A54. Okay, fine. Now, what is more than? Which term? Which term they are asking? I do not know the term. N, I do not know. So, let me take AN is equal to. Okay, AN. Why I have taken AN? Because I do not know which term. N gotilla nange. So, I have taken it as AN. Initially, to find 0 also, I took AN is equal to 0. Here also, I am going to take AN is equal to what? Will be 132 more. So, 132 more plus than what? Arthaita, they are telling N value. AN will be 132. Okay. You are not going to get less than 132. Okay, fine. And it is more than 54. And it is more than 54. Okay. Now, we are going to find the term. That is N value we are going to find. Now let me write the sequence. 3, 15, 27, 39. Yes? So this is A1, A2, A3, A4. Now what is the first term? A1 will always be equal to first term, which is equal to 3. Then D is equal to, since I am writing it horizontally, you can write it vertically also. D na kelak barru paravagila allo barru paravagila, it is your choice. So let me make sure that you book your notes look neat. That's all. So A2 is 15 minus 3. 15 minus 3 is 12. Correct? Then D is equal to A3 minus A2, which is equal to what is the value? 27 minus 15. 5. 7 minus 5 is 2. 2 minus 1 is also 2. Now here only let me do 9 minus 7 is 2 and 3 minus 1 is also 3 minus 2 is also 1. So the D value got constant. Now what I am going to do? Now I am going to find out this. Find out A54. Okay. Which term? So you are going to find the nth term. Let me check once again. This is 11th sum. Yeah, you are going to find out the nth term. Now we are not going to find this value. Okay? Why? Because let me make you easier. Let me find this value. Let me find A54th term. Okay? If I find A54th term, I can substitute here. So, two constants will be there. I can add and I can find out the n value using the general formula, that is a is equal to n minus a plus n minus 1 into d. Using that, I can find out where I know a and d value. Okay, let me find A54th term. So, A54, how am I going to write A54? A plus n minus 1 into d, which is equal to a plus 54 minus 1 into d, which is equal to a plus 53 d. So what is the value of a? What is the value of a, children? 3. Plus what is the value of d? It is 12. 53 into 12. So now you are going to multiply 53 into 12. Correct? If you know 12 table, you can go ahead. If you do not know, you can do it with 2 and 1. So 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10, plus 3, 5, 6, 3, 6. Correct? So, A54 will be equal to 6, 3, 6. Now, I got to know that A54th term is 6, 3, 6 plus 3. Your 3 is there. So, it is 6, 3, 9. A54 will be equal to 6, 3, 9. Correct? So it is 54 minus 1, 53 d, d is 12. So it is 2, 6, 2, 3 is 6, 2, 5 is 10, plus 2, 1, 2, 3 is, sorry, 1, 3 is 3, 1, 5 is 5, 6, 3, 6. Okay, plus 3, so it is 6, 3, 9. Now I got to know the 54th term. Let me substitute in this equation. Yeah, if I substitute it in this equation, what do I get? Let's see. Write the equation. So it is a n is equal to 132 plus a 54. So how are you going to write a n as? What is the formula for a n? A plus n minus 1 into d. Very good. 132 plus what is a 54? Of our answer, children, it is 639. Okay. Then what is the value of a? The value of a is 3 plus n minus 1. What is the value of d? The value of d is 12, which is equal to 9 plus 12. 9 plus 2 is 11. 1 carry. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. 6 plus 1 is 7. You get 771. Check. 9, 10, 11, 1 carry. 3 plus 3 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. 6 plus 1 is also 7. Yeah. Now it is 3 plus 12 into n is 12n. Plus into minus is minus. 12 which is equal to 177. Now take everything that is the constant you are going to take. Constant is 3 and minus 12, but 12n is the alphanumerical term. Let me keep it as it is. 12n is equal to 771. My plus 3 becomes minus 3, plus minus 12 becomes 12, plus 12. Correct? So it is 12n is equal to 771. In 12, if my 3 goes, how much children? 9. Correct? In 12, if 3 goes, how much? 9. Then 12n is equal to, here it is 780. Correct? 9 plus 1 is 10, and 7 plus 1 is 8. You get 780. So n value will be equal to 780 divided by 12. If you know 12 ones, you can cancel it in 12 ones. If you do not know, you can do it with 2 ones itself. I know 12 ones, that is 2, 12, 6 are 72. Correct? So it is 12, 6 are 72. You will be left with 6. That it becomes 60. 12, 5 are 60. So n value will be equal to 65. Okay? N value will be equal to 65. Now, the 65th term will be the addition of these two. That is 171. The total of this 56th term will be equal to 171. I hope this question is understood for you. What they have given? They have given you the sequence. They have asked, that is nth term. I do not know which term. That term will be 132 plus the A54th term. So 132 plus the A54th term. I'll find out the value of A. Why? Because the sequence is given. Then I'll find out the D value. Since I wanted A54th term, why I wanted, you can also put the formula here also, children. A plus. You can put 53D, then AA gets cancelled, like that also you can do, okay. But I want you to be in the safer cell, that is, it should be very easy to you. So I found out the 54th term where I get 639, then I substituted it, I got a number, then I'll do subtraction, the simple subtraction and division I'll do, so that I get n value which is equal to 65th term. So for the which term, see that is, the nth term will be equal to 65th term. Correct? So, the 11th question is understood. Now, let me go to the example question. Till 6th example I have done, but I have not done the 7th example. Today I will be doing the 7th example. Okay? Example questions will not be given, children. And I am telling you, please do practice these sums, okay, that is from the 7th question, from 7th question to the 20th question, nothing is there. Only 1-1 type sums only they have given with different concepts. Okay, only 1-1 type. So better you do both in classwork as well as homework. Why? I wanted you to be very clear with the topic. Okay, so make sure that you write it in both classwork and as well as in homework. I want you to be very sure with the topic. I do not want any question marks to be there when I ask you things. Okay. Yeah. Let me take and example sums. It is not necessary. If you want, you can write. And example sums, I won't ask you whether you have written or not. If it is your choice. It is my responsibility to teach you. It is your choice. If you want to write the example sums, you can write. If you do not want, you cannot. Okay. It is your choice to write it as well as in homework or classwork. It is your choice. But do all the sums in the book. And in the PDF also, you won't get the example questions. No, I won't give the example questions. How many two-digit numbers are divisible by 3? So what they are telling, how many? I do not know. How many? N term, I do not know. Two digit numbers, okay, are divisible by 3. So in your number sequence, from where does the two digit number starts? I cannot write as 0-2. 2 digit, ma'am, no. 0-2 is 2 itself. I do not want it in this form. From where it starts? From 10, correct? From 10 it starts and till where it goes? Till where it goes, children? Till 99. After 99, what you have? 100. It is 3 digit number. No, they are asking only the 2 digit number. So it starts from 10 and it ends from end still 99, correct? What is the condition they have given? First condition was 2 digit number. So yes, we have taken 2 digit number. Then what is the next condition? It should be divisible by 3. It should be divisible by 3. Now we are going to do each and every term. 10. 10 divided by 3. Does 10 divide 3? No. I want a whole number. I do not want a decimal. No. Cancel. Then 11 divides 3? No. 12 divides 3? Yes. 3 ones are 3. 4s are 12. So 12 is the first number. Then 13? No. 14? No. 15? Yes. 3 5s are 15. Then 3 6s are 18. 3 7s are 21. And it goes on up to which is the last number? 99. Does 99 divided by 3? Yes. 3 33 divided by 99. Yes. Did you understand how to take this? Aptaita, 3 1s are tables. 3 1s are tables. Yes. In the 2 decimal form, agate. 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12. So 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 18, 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 3 9s are 27, 3 10s are 30, and it goes to 3 33s are 99. 3 34 it becomes 3 digit number. It will be 12 1 1 0 1 1 2. Okay, 3 34 it will be 3 into 34 it has been 1 1 2. I do not want that. So these are the things, these are the numbers. Okay, now the sequence is ready for you. What are you going to do? You are going to number the sequence. If we take the three terms itself, I do not want to make it very lengthy. And the nth term, I do not know. So let me take it. How many nth term can I write? I know it is 3 into 33 is 99. I cannot write 3 into 33 is equal to 99. No. It is not a fifth standard. You need to use the formula and do the sum. Okay, then what are the things? A1 is equal to A, which is equal to 12. Then D is equal to A2 minus A1, which is equal to, what is A2 value? 60, 15 minus 12. That is 3 itself. Then D, A3 minus A2, which is equal to 18 minus 15, which is also equal to, correct? So D value got. Now I need to find AN. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. What is AN value you have known? That is 99 is equal to, what is A value? 12 plus 3 minus 1 into, sorry. N minus 1 into 3. So 99 is equal to 12 plus 3 into N, 3N. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. So if minus 3, that is 12 minus 3 is 9, correct? 12 minus 3 is 9 plus 3n. 12 minus 3 is 9 plus 3n. Then if minus 9 comes this side, plus 9 comes this side, it becomes minus 9. 99 minus 9 is equal to 3n. So it will be 90. So it will be 90. That is 90 is equal to 3n. N will be equal to 90 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3 threes are 90. So how many terms has been divisible? 30 terms. 30 two digit numbers has been divisible by 3. Why it is 30? Because it starts from 3 fours are and it ends with 3 33s are. So 3 terms up 1. So 33 minus 3 is 30 itself. So how many terms? 30 terms. Did you understand this much? Yeah. Let me wind the class till here itself. So please do complete the things. And worksheet is also been uploaded. Okay. You do not set your mind that only those type of questions will be coming. No, you will be having, because I have given only one exercise as the worksheet. And the next exercise I have not prepared. I will prepare it and I will put it. Please do work hard, children, to score more marks. Thank you very much.